Lydia Alsai from the East Hackensack Congregation, and Brother Adam Neshin from the Woodcliff Lake Congregation. Well, you young people, we know that you love serving Jehovah, but we need to find out how you came to that decision yourselves. Sister Alsai, how did your parents help you learn the truth?
From a very early age, when my parents learned the truth, they never held back from giving honor to Jehovah, and they always made an effort to teach my brother and I from the Bible about him. They also taught us to appreciate Jehovah's wonderful creation and how it gives evidence of his love for us. We always knew that Saturday was our service day. When we were little, my parents made sure that we were prepared, and we learned to love it. We also tried out different avenues of service, which was fun.
Very nice. Brother Neshin?
My parents have high standards for helping and encouraging me about the truth. Even when I was born, my parents didn't take off a service day just because I was a baby. They still went out and brought me along as well. When my parents and I have our studies, they really take the time to teach me about things that I don't understand 100%. When certain problems arose in the past, my parents helped reason with me with the help of Bible scriptures to not just teach me commands, but more importantly, the reason behind the actions. As Hebrews 5:14 brings out, that through use, our perceptive powers are trained to distinguish both right and wrong.
Thank you. Appreciate those expressions. Tell us, Sister Alsai, when was it and why did you recognize the value of knowing Jehovah and of doing His will?
It wasn't always easy. When I entered middle school, I wanted to fit in, to be accepted by my classmates. At that point, I didn't have a lot of friends, so whenever the kids at school would invite me to hang out with them, I was tempted to do so.
So young people can relate, wanting to fit in, wanting friends, being tempted by wrong associations?
Definitely, but I started to notice the problems of my peers and the pain that their decisions caused them. It helped me to see that the religion I'm in does serve as a protection for me, and it made me want to draw closer to Jehovah. When I was 13, I got baptized. We always have Bethelites and pioneers over our house, and just hearing their experiences and their example helped me to set the same goal.
Thank you. Brother Neshin?
To the age of about 10, I learned the basics of Jehovah and the Bible, but didn't understand the meaning of what I was learning. Even to the age of 13, I learned more than just the basics, but still didn't realize if I wanted to be part of Jehovah's organization. So about the time I was in middle school, about the age of 14, with the help of my parents and other brothers and sisters in the hall, I began to realize the importance of Jehovah's will. So the following year, when I was 15, I dedicated myself to Jehovah and was baptized.
Thank you for your honesty. We appreciate it. Finally, what factors contribute to your joy in doing God's will whole soul?
One thing for sure, I've been able to make a good friendship with Jehovah. We all rely on Jehovah greatly, but as a regular pioneer, you really learn to trust in Him and trust that even with difficulties, He will never leave you. We all face different issues, but Jehovah shows that He cares for me, He understands, and He will help me to get through it. I've been able to experience firsthand the excitement of sharing the good news with others and actually getting a favorable response. Also, the past year has brought me closer to my brother, who started regular pioneering with me, and to my fellow spiritual brothers and sisters, many of them my own age. I've made so many friends, and Jehovah has shown me that I'm not alone in serving Him. I can honestly say that this has been the best year of my life.
That's beautiful to hear. And Brother Neshin, what brings you joy in doing God's will as a young person?
Well, the very first thing is that I know I am serving Jehovah and making Him happy. I love going out in ministry, and by frequently auxiliary pioneering, I could do just that. And also, by going out in ministry more often, I have the privilege to develop better relationships with the brothers and sisters while we're out in ministry. In this past summer, I participated in Seldom Marked Territory and was able to develop friendships with the brothers and sisters there. And one last factor is that I have more responsibilities in the congregation, and it brings me joy to be used in Jehovah's organization.
Thank you. We appreciate and love you, young people, as Jehovah does.